Hi, I'm Sandata Yet Villarreal Jr. Welcome to Video Assisted Instruction Data File Structure and Algorithm Series. Right now is our lecture number 8. Let's proceed to our topic for today. So our topic for today is about linked lists. So linked list is an abstract data type, ADT, that holds a collection of nodes. The nodes can be accessed in a sequential way. Linked list doesn't provide a random access to a node. If it is accessed sequentially, it means to say this is an increment. Now, in figure 15 shows a linked list abstract data type. You will notice we have A, B, C, D as data, and A is considered to be the head of this data, and this data is considered to be sequential, one step at a time. If it is an alphabet, then it should be A, B, C, D. So this head, it is considered to be displayed on the screen, but if you're going to press next like a button, then letter B will display. If you're going to click next, then letter C will display. And if you're going to click next, then letter D is going to display. The data of A, B, C, D are considered to be sequential, and that is not random. Another is the first data who's going to display first is considered to be the head. Now, let's move on to a double linked list. A double linked list is the same. There is a what do you call previous. So, we have a data here, A, B, C, D also, the same as in a linked list. And this is considered to be double linked list. The idea is that there is a what you call button also, which is called previous, this one. So if you're going to click previous, it will go back to letter C, data. Then if you're going to click previous, it will go letter B, data, and up to the head, because this is the beginning. The last one is what you call the tail. So it is the same as a text box that you're going to input the data. And there is what you call next and previous button. If there is a next and previous button, it is called a double linked list. If there is only a next button, this is called to be a linked list only. Let's proceed. So right here, we have the ARI implementation of linked list. How does linked list works in a program? Okay, we have here. So this is the complete program and algorithm of linked list, ARI and pointer, which is indicated on our syllabus. And if you're going to put this into our Visual Studio and run by C or C++, you can have code and even the output of the linked list using an array and using a pointer. Now right here, this is very common to us, sharp include sdi.h. It is a preprocessor and it is a header file, and there is what you call predefined and declares as maximum as a function 10. Now we have the struct. It is identified as structure, then begin and end, which is very common because we are programming on it. Now we have int list, and the max is 10. It means to say this is an array, because 10 is max, and by the algorithm we use max, which has equivalent of 10, open and close bracket 10, and this is considered to be array list. So we have the variable element, pos, and length. Then we have the enum boolean, true or false. Okay, so we have the enumeration or enumerative boolean, true or false. Then we have the type definition, type def, the same of define. Okay, they are all function, enum, boolean, and boolean. And look at this, we have the function prototype. And we have integer menu. So we have menu here, and it has been put up as create, insert, delete, and find. And again, they're going to locate the data or the elements on the list. And of course, we have exit, display, then we have the boolean. So this is the main program, which identifies only 1, it's 0, while length is 0. If it is case 2, then again, if it is, this is case 1, 0, and we have case 3 is true, okay, full and empty. And we have case 4, is something like a break. 5 is the same, display of the length and the element. We have the exit, number 7. So don't forget to press 7 just in case we want to exit. And that is the code. And here is the main menu function. This will be the first who are going to display this code, okay? Because this is the main menu function. And we have the void create. It meant to say it goes like something like create this one, 1. If you press 1, it will go directly to create void. So if you press 2, so it will go directly to number 2, and that is insert. Okay, then we have delete and we have find. So this is a complete program, the linked list. Now let's move to the output. So if you're going to create, you're going to press 1, like right here, which I have been discussed on the code. So this is the display only, up to enter your choice, and this is not yet a display. So press 1, then enter element 5, which is the data. To insert another element, press 1. So they press 1, then insert another element or enter element. So they put data 10, so we have 2 data, 5, 10. Then to insert another element, press 1 again. So 1, enter element 15. So we have a data of 5, 10, 15. Now if you're going to ask me, where is the head? We have 5. Where's the tail? We have 15. 6 is display. To insert another element, press 1, a display of what he make. So we have here, press 6, then you will notice it displays element 1, 5, 10, 15. So this is what you call the list. And the list is considered to be sequential. It will not jump because it has a number or a pattern like 1, 2, 3. On the first data, you have 5. On the second data, you have 10. And the third data, you have 15. So that's it. Now, fundamental of linked list using pointers. A linked list is a sequence of data structure which are connected together via links. So linked list is a sequence of link which contains items. Each link contains a connection to another link. Linked list is the second most used data structure after array. And that is true, which I'm doing right now in the PowerPoint presentation. Following are the important terms to understand the concept of linked list. The first one is link. Each link of a linked list can store a data called an element. Number 2 is next. Each link of a linked list contains a link to the next link called next. And the last linked list, a linked list contains the connection link to the first link called first. A reality of what is a linked list. So there is a text right here, there is an image right here, but if you're going to point out on the text, so it goes to the link, look at that. See users Villarreal desktop adding node to linked list program doc. And this is one part of the implementation of linked list. So we have here C++ implementation add node to linked list program. So we have the void. The void is one of the data type in C. Okay, you can specify what kind of function. Make it sure it has its open and close parentheses. The use is if new node null return 0 if empty. If not, next, then null. Then it goes to the head automatic because that is the beginning. And the last one is the tail. And if there's a tail, there's a next, it means to say you're going to add. Or rather, it will go back like a double linked list. It is what you called previous. So the same process here. So here is add last, and this one is add first. So you can add to the last part of the tail to make a new node, and here it will add at the beginning of the data. And right here is after. In any data you have, you can insert on that. And that's what you called after. And these are the codes of the implementation in C++ by adding node. So if I said node, it is the same as data. So next, displaying the content of a linked list. So we have here figure 16 show a displaying the content of a linked list. Node 1, node 2, node 3. Then you will notice the explanation here is there is a data, and there's a memory of the next node. So it means to say this is what you call the sequence. So the data right here is having a sequence right here. Then again, the same process. There's a what you call data and the memory address of the next node. The next node is right on the number 3. If we're going to identify the memory, automatically it is considered to be a pointer because it is already on the memory. And data must be classified into a variable or into a memory. It means to say it can be classified as array and pointer and even the standard variable. So it should be 3 to make you aware of what we are talking about. So for example, a is equals to 15. So this is a variable a which has 15 value. The memory address of the next node is 2000. It means to say this node 2 is 2000. The address of this. If the address of this has been used, we need to use pointer. Okay, to point out that in 2000, do not move this, we have 20 right here as data. And in 1000, do not move this, we have 15 as data in the node 1. And it's the same as in the node 3, there's a what you call the 300 in terms of 3000 in terms of memory, and the value is 25. And we have an error here. So this is node 1, 2, and node 3. And it specifies node 2. And again, this is node 3. So that is the idea of the sequence on how this link process and display the content. It means to say the succeeding data is considered to be always ready. Next topic is searching an item in a linked list. So searching in a linked list is a sequential search, is the most common search used on linked list structure. And the algorithm of that is step 1, initialize the current pointer with the beginning of the list. The pointer we use as asterisk and we use ampersand. Step 2, compare the key value with the current node. If they match, then quit. Then else go to step 3. So it means to say, if you have a pointer and if you are using the ampersand and the asterisk, so you can use relational operation because you're going to use here relational in terms of the decision if, because if is a decision statement. So if it is true, then match. If it is not, then out. So step 3, move the current pointer to the point to the next node in the list and go to step 2 till the list is not over or else quit. It means to say it will go to the next step rather than quitting. If has a data to the next sequence, it can be called also as adjacent storage in terms of programming. So the code right here, search an element in a linked list, this is very similar, I already discussed this, and we have something like memory allocation as malloc.h. It is what you call the memory allocation. M for memory and alloc is allocation. And we have here the structure. And the name of the structure is node, but it is not a database. That's why it's called data structure. Now begin integer data, struct node, then we have a pointer. That is what been mentioned on the algorithm. It should be on the pointer and you're going to point out the data and there should be a sequence of data. Pointer right here, then we have the search, then void main. So this is the beginning of the code, programmer's code. Now if we're going to check out, so enter the number of nodes you want in linked list, so 7, and it will display the 7. And you will notice that we do this in terms of array, item, position, for I, increment, and we have the struct, that's it. So they use struct as an array, okay? Because right here, we declare struct. And structure is, the meaning of structure is a set of array variable. So if you are not aware of this, it is an advanced data type, okay, in programming. I use this especially on saving data and storing that into a memory without deleting the file. And it goes to the pointer, which is the memory variable. Then the memory variable, they put it on the data. Enter the node 7, then node 1, there's 34, 56, 67, 87, 3, 0, 1. It should be sequential. Now enter item to be searched, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And that is on the number 6 node. And it is correct. Next, we have programming with linked list. By the way, don't forget, I will going to save this or send this into Facebook and Microsoft Teams in our group so that you can study it more. And copy this and put this into your Visual Studio. Next, we have 3.3 programming with linked list, inserting node, insertion and deletion, application using linked list, which already we've been discussed. The other is linked list structure, double linked list, and circular linked list. The only topic we didn't discuss is the circular linked list. It is the same as the previous discussion, like this one. So it should be in a sequence, or it should be in a chain because they are synonymous. One at a time, there is what do you call the next. The first data is the head and the last is the tail. There are types of linked lists: simple linked list, double linked list, and circular linked list. And again, we are not yet discuss the circular linked list. Basic operation: insert, deletion, display, search, and delete. This is very basic in programming and databases. The discussion is right here on the figure itself. And we have here the third linked list, which is the circular linked list. In figure 17, show a circular linked list, abstract data type. A circular linked list can be a single linked list or a double linked list. In a double circular linked list, the previous pointer of the first node is connected to the last node, while the next pointer of the last node is connected to the first node. Now, to become aware of what is a circular linked list is at the end of the data. If the data is N4, then it will go back to N1 by not going to N3, okay? And if it is on N1, it can go directly to the, if it is the head, it can goes directly to the tail, okay? So N1 goes directly to the N4, and that is a circular linked list. I use this in the database to make it more faster on searching about the data or the name of the client or person. So validation board, that is a linked list. That's all for today. Thank you for watching and good luck. Congratulations, you successfully finished our lecture number 8.